Have you heard of the word 양우산? 양우산. No, it's not a name. It combines the word 양산, parasol, and 우산, umbrella. So in English, it could be something like parabrella. It can be used for both sun shading and rain protection. It's something we desperately need these days, what with the heavy downpour followed by the blazing sun. So here's a fun thought. What if I said someone is like a 양우산? Such a person is adaptable and excels in rapidly changing situations. Somewhat of a truly well-rounded character. So now, let me ask you, does anyone want to be like a 양우산 type of person? Just tell me. Hi everyone, welcome to Enjoy Weekend. I'm your DJ, Ayoung Shin. We opened our show with Umbrella by Rihanna featuring Jay-Z. Hello everyone, I'm your DJ Ayoung Shin and you are listening to Enjoy Weekend. Every Saturday morning from 7 a.m. to 8 a.m. we will be here. So please tune in to 90.7 megahertz. If you have any stories to tell us or any song requests, you can send in your messages to hashtag 9070. Short messages are 51, while longer ones are 101. There are also two free options. You can use our KakaoTalk channel or the Kyungin Broadcasting application. To use them, download the Kyungin Broadcasting application or add the Enjoy Weekend channel as a friend on KakaoTalk. Okay, it's time for our first segment, so let's get started. Shall we travel through time with music? Come on, hop on the time machine. We'll visit the past, present, or the future, so any time period based on some of my personal experiences. So I'm doing this in the hopes that we'll get to know each other and get closer. So for today's journey, I am taking us back to... Okay, I don't know if you all have watched it, but the Olympic opening ceremony, I saw Celine Dion perform and it took me right back to 1998 because Titanic was the first movie that I saw with my parents that wasn't a cartoon. So basically, it wasn't about animals solving mysteries and just suddenly breaking out into a song. It was like an adult movie that actually made sense. And say what you will about the ending, but I think that music made the ending work. I thought that movie was the most wonderful thing I've ever set my eyes on. Even if I didn't understand it completely at the time. And the soundtrack still haunts me. And I still can't get over how beautiful this song is. And some of you movie fanatics will say, oh, the movie came out in 1997. Why are you saying 1998? Because I watched it a year later. So it's completely based on my experience. So I would like to take us back to 1998 when I first saw the movie Titanic. So this is Celine Dion's My Heart Will Go On. Let's meet the numerous lives thriving in Incheon and life surviving in Incheon. Since the weather is getting extremely hot, I brought some news today to help us survive the heat. Okay, first up is that the Ministry of Employment and Labor is inspecting workplaces for heat stress throughout this week until August 7th. They're checking 120 workplaces where foreign workers are exposed to high heat, looking at both work and living conditions. They're also handing out and posting a heat illness prevention guide in 17 languages for foreign workers. This guide helps them understand heat safety and respond quickly to emergencies. In addition, the city of Incheon is advising residents to take precautions due to high ozone levels expected with the heat after the rainy season. They monitor ozone levels in real time and have an alert system. When there's an ozone advisory, residents should stay indoors and avoid outdoor activities. So be sure to sign up for the alerts and stay inside during these times. It's time for 생존 한국어, Survival Korean. Today's word is 찜통더위. Ugh, 찜통더위 combines the word 찜통, which means steamer, and 더위, heat, to describe the extreme summer heat that you will be experiencing in Korea. So it's a purely Korean term. The closest English term that I can think of is maybe scorching heat, right? So it burns, right? But we tend to, in Korean, we tend to describe it more, I guess, euphorically by saying that we're living in a 찜통, like we're being steamed, like we're a couple of dumplings. So Koreans actually humorously post on social media saying things like, hey, dumpling, it's going to get even hotter soon, so hang in there, like don't burn, you know? So, okay, dumplings, don't forget to drink plenty of water. You don't want to dry out, and take breaks in cool places when it's really, really hot. Also, remember to ventilate and control the temperature in enclosed spaces like cars. It's important to stay healthy. Okay, now shall we listen to another song? Oh, this is cooling. It's Ice Cream by Mika. Do you want to taste Korean culture? Take a bite of original Korean music. In this segment, I'll share some stories about K-pop in general, and we'll listen to some timeless quality songs. There will be two songs like always. One is a relatively recent hit, and the other is related but more old generation K-pop. So, let's meet today's recent singer, and that is IU. I mean, what more can I say? It's IU. She's currently on a world tour, which began in Seoul and has traveled through Asia, Europe, and the Americas. With her hit songs, 좋은 날, 너랑 나, Blooming, she is one of the most famous female singers in Korea today. Since her debut in 2008, she has become incredibly popular and continues to showcase her remarkable talent. But not only is she a highly skilled singer, but she also writes songs and lyrics. And some of you already know that IU is also a wonderful actress. Using her real name, Lee Ji-eun, she demonstrates outstanding acting skills as a lead in both dramas and in films. And last but not least, IU has also remade many classic hits from other senior Korean artists. So we've picked one singer among them for today's related singer. But more on that later. For now, let's listen to 너의 의미. That was 너의 의미 by IU featuring Kim Chang-won. So if you know, you know. Yes, the song was a spoiler. Yes, the related singer is Hanul-nim. And one of Hanul-nim's best song is this, 너의 의미. Hanul-nim is actually a rock band, the GOAT, right? The greatest of all time. The group is composed of three brothers. Kim Chang-won is on vocals and guitar, Kim Chang-hoon, vocals and bass, and the late Kim Chang-ik, he plays the drums. They represent Korean rock music, and many artists like IU have been influenced by Hanul-nim. Their song is very unique and high-quality classic songs, including 나 어떻게, 아니 벌써, 내 마음에 주단을 깔고, 청춘, 회상, and 산할아버지. They debuted in 1977, so way before we were born, I was born, and released 14 studio albums. However, after drummer Kim Chang-ik passed away in an unfortunate accident, they announced the end of their activities in 2008. And since then, Kim Chang-hoon has been active as a solo artist and formed the band Black Stones, while Kim Chang-won formed the Kim Chang-won Band. And now let's listen to one of 산울림's songs. It's 아니 벌써. Hey, hey, is everything okay? Tell me about it.
I had a tough day yesterday.
I know, same here.
Tell me about it.
We collect every stories from your lives. Just
tell us about it.
Hey, Greg, good to see you again.
Woo!
I'm good. How about you?
I'm good. I'm always great when I come here.
Right, right.
How are you doing? You're good?
Uh-huh. Yeah. Actually, you know Tottenham Hotspur and Bayern Munich, they visited Korea.
I heard,
so,
yeah.
Yeah, I went to their game.
Oh, my goodness. How was it? The atmosphere it must great. Be crazy.
It was great. And actually, there's a game happening today on Saturday.
Perfect.
So if you guys are going,
perfect
it promises
chance,
to be a fun game.
Get out there and enjoy
so,
it.
Yeah. What about you? What's new with you?
Just working on new music and
ooh.
Stuff. Yeah. A song recently came out. I guess that would have been Thursday of this week at 6. That was Sohyang's new song. And it's called To You Love Me Again. And actually, I'm one of the writers on that song.
So that is exciting.
Hope you all have been listening.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. We'll get into that.
Yeah,
okay.
Sure.
Okay, that's great. Shall we just dive into this next segment?
Let's do it. I love it. Of course, tell us about it. Literally needs your stories. So if you want to share your stories with us, you can send in any stories and your song request as well. Send your messages to hashtag 9070. Short messages cost 51, while longer messages cost 101. But there's some free options as well. Everyone loves free. The Kakao Talk channel or the Gyeongin Broadcasting application.
Okay, that was great.
I'm working. Greg. I practiced a little bit.
Okay. Maybe you should take this one as well.
Well, let's
go
do
for it.
Here we go. First message today from 2353. They said, I'm an American exchange student in Korea. Welcome. What really surprised me here are the delivery food options and 24-hour restaurants.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. I'm ready to say tell me about it already, but they have more. We have them in the States, too. But in Korea, everything is so fast and available. I'm totally hooked now. I'm getting addicted to all of the delivery. So I think it'll be a bit tough going back to the U.S. later.
Tell me about it.
We agree.
I know.
We're like, yes, 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 and yes, right?
I know. So many food options. 24-hour restaurants.
Day.
I know.
Isn't it crazy? And then you visit other places and you feel disappointed.
I know. Like living in Korea, especially like growing up in Seoul,
yeah, right?
You get so used to that.
Exactly.
Right?
It's the norm.
And then you go to like maybe someplace in Europe and they all close
anywhere.
Out in like 6
oh, sorry,
or like
we close
5.
At 7 today. What?
I know.
Like, are you serious?
It's like you guys don't eat dinner? Like
no, not after 7 p.m. We closed. Or they'll have like even an afternoon, you know, siesta or like a break time and they're just closed for 4 hours. And like, what do you do for lunch? You have to do it until 12.
I know.
After that, you're up the creek.
I know. So, I mean, it's so convenient, right?
Oh, so addictive. So I understand where you're coming from, 2353.
So enjoy it while you're here is
right.
all I'm saying.
But I've heard other places are starting to pick up the pace
yeah,
on delivery.
Yeah. Especially America.
Yes,
yeah.
Very much so. Next day delivery, same day delivery.
Yeah, it's like the drones and everything, right? Technology.
Yeah, it's cool.
So
hang in there.
But I think, I'm just going to say this, Korea does it best. So.
Hands down best.
Yeah, enjoy it while you're here.
Now get this. You go to the park. You're sitting in the park.
Oh my God, I know.
What's the address in the park? Nobody knows. You just pinpoint it and you send it to them and they come to you in the park.
I know.
Now that's delivery. I'm talking
so
about
fast.
What? They find you in the park.
So convenient. I know. I know.
Wow.
I think we started. It's safe to say that we started or we've perfected,
I think perfected
the delivery system.
Yeah, perfected. Maybe started and perfected,
yeah.
right?
Okay.
Ugh, amazing.
Okay, we got a little
oh,
bit
we're too excited.
Excited, right? Okay.
So, anyway.
Okay, shall we meet the next story?
Let's do it. It's from 1107. They said, I'm left-handed and in my country, it doesn't matter where you're left-handed or right-handed. However, I learned that in Korea, people tend to prefer right-handedness. If a child is left-handed, their parents often try to encourage them to use their right hand instead. Ayoung, Greg, are you left-handed or right-handed? Uh-oh. Dun, 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 dun. Are you left or right?
I'm right-handed.
You're right.
I'm a righty.
Uh-oh. So you're in your left mind, they say.
Well, that's what they say scientifically, right?
I'm just joking.
What about you?
I'm a lefty.
Oh, really? Really? Oh.
Yeah, in a family full of right-handed people. So they're all like, what are you doing over there? But actually, when I was growing up, left-handedness was a little weird, too.
I know. For me, too, I guess. I mean, you say that the parents try to encourage them these days, but back in our days,
Like,
it was like they were trying to correct them.
Yeah, fix it.
Yeah. So I think we're getting better at this. But I mean, I think in all cultures, there's kind of like that slight, like, unconscious fear of being different, of standing out. Yeah. But I think we're getting better.
I had a teacher who would swat my hand if I... Yeah. Wrote with my left hand. So actually, I was ambidextrous, left and right-handed when I was young. Because she'd say, Greg, no, write with your right hand. Yes, ma'am. And I'd switch. But I'm left-handed, ultimately.
But it doesn't really matter.
Yeah, it's okay.
Yeah, we don't really write anything. So we type and like text. So it doesn't,
When you do sports and stuff, are you still right? Or
I'm very right.
Oh, you're dominant
right.
Yeah, I do sports right-handed.
Really?
Yeah, I pitch right-handed. I bowl right-handed. But I only write left-handed.
You know, there's this saying, like, being ambidextrous means that you're a genius. So
does it?
I think so, yeah.
Comes up new. So.
Yay, you.
I was waiting to get some validation.
Okay. So don't worry too much about it.
Just
enjoy
your life, right?
Yeah. Okay. Cool. Okay, let's wrap up this discussion here.
Sure.
And we'll listen to the song Thunder by Imagine Dragons. And now hold on to your breath because we go
Drama Queen.
In this sub-segment, we'll turn your stories into a drama. Ooh. So today's original story came from 5648. Last weekend, I went to a high school friend's gathering, and there was a bit of an awkward moment.
Hey, girl.
Hi. Oh, my God. You look gorgeous.
It's been forever, but you look even prettier. How come?
Aw, you're too kind. Nothing's really changed. I mean, you look good too.
Well, of course I do. But I know something's up. You must have had plastic surgery. Look at her nose.
What do you mean? I've had this, like, old thing for, like, my whole life. The same nose.
And you even lost weight. Oh, did you break up? Huh?
What? You know... No.
Guys, why are you all focusing on her? Let her order a drink.
And after that, they didn't talk about me anymore because we had a lot to catch up on. But they weren't completely wrong about everything they said. But on my way home, I didn't feel too good. What do you think of this situation? Okay, I think I've been in this scene. Like, I've been there, right?
Haven't we all, right? When you're suddenly the center of attention where you don't necessarily want to be.
Drama.
Right. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
How do you deal with this situation?
I know.
Yeah.
So, I mean, like, there's nothing wrong with plastic surgery.
Honestly, there's not. Yeah. And if you didn't pay for it, you don't get to comment on it.
Right on.
You don't have the receipt, then you can just be quiet. That's my mind.
And who really cares about, you know, getting plastic surgery anyway? It's kind of for your...
It's your body.
Yeah.
It's
for
you.
It's for you.
If you paid for it, then you can talk to me about it. But other than that, I don't really hear anything about it.
But, I mean, to be fair, I think the friends were a little bit mean to her.
But friend one was definitely doing too much.
Yeah.
I felt bad saying the things friend one was saying. Oh, you look different. Did you break up? Are you so slim? Did you have plastic surgery? It was all judgmental.
Even if you're friends, you shouldn't really
That's
say
not
those
the way to say
things.
It. Like, yeah. Girl, did you get some work done? You look great.
I know. You should just stay with that. You look great.
You can lead into it. You look fantastic. What are you up to these days?
Yeah.
Let them tell you.
Exactly.
If they choose to.
Right.
You know?
Don't pry.
Yeah, that's so rude.
That's
you must
mean.
Have had plastic surgery. Maybe she actually had a diet change or health issues. Who knows?
Exactly. So, there was that kind of like that underhanded kind
it,
of
it was
like
very
insult. I mean, if the friend won, if she meant that,
yeah, right.
Then you rude girl.
You're really doing too much. You're doing a lot.
You shouldn't be doing that.
She should have fired back at him. Oh, did you go to the same clinic? Like,
yeah, I know.
Wow. But it happens. It does happen. We have what they call frenemies sometimes.
Frenemies, right. Oh, such a good term. I don't know who first coined that term.
Yeah,
it just explains everything, right?
The dynamics between,
kind of like a love-hate relationship. Right.
I had a friend like that, you know, still talking about everything. I always post on every video I upload, but there's always those
like underhanded kind of like insult. Like they try to sneak it in there.
These little jabs.
Oh my God, Greg, you are such a good singer, but you didn't sing that well.
You were kind of flat that day, weren't you?
Yeah. Oh, like is something wrong? I don't know.
your condition was bad that day?
Yeah.
You're a good singer, though. Like,
they think it's clever. They think it's clever, but it's not. Okay.
It makes me hot. Anyway.
Okay. Oh, my God. We are getting so worked up, right?
Gotta relax.
Yeah. Okay. I think we should kind of like, I don't know, change the scenery.
Okay.
Change the vibe a little bit.
Switch things up.
With your song.
Okay. Of course. I think I have a good response to this one.
Okay. I'm looking forward to it. Right. What is the title of the song?
Well, I thought you need to remember for yourself that you are beautiful. So I went with Christina Aguilera. Beautiful.
Ooh, I think I know which song. Yeah. Okay. Okay. It's a live gift. Let's give a round of applause for Greg. Whee!
Every day is so wonderful, then suddenly it's hard to breathe. Now and then I get insecure from all the pain. I'm so ashamed. I am beautiful no matter what they say. Words can't bring me down. I am beautiful in every single way. Yes, words can't bring me down. So don't you bring me down today. All your friends, you're delirious, so consumed in all your doom. Trying hard to fill the emptiness, the peace is gone. Let the puzzle undone. But you are beautiful, no matter what they say. Words can't bring you down. You are beautiful in every single way. Yes, words can't bring you down. So don't you bring me down today. No matter what we do, no matter what we say, with a song inside the tune, full of beautiful mistakes. And everywhere we go, that the sun will always shine. Oh, yeah. You are beautiful, no matter what they say. Yes, words can't bring you down. Oh. We are beautiful in every single way. Yes, words won't bring us down. Oh. So don't you bring me down. So don't you bring me down today.
Ooh.
Yeah. Don't bring us down, right? You're beautiful. Mm.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Greg, for that. I think we all needed to hear that.
It's a good reminder.
Yeah.
Look in the mirror, love yourself.
Exactly, yep. Exactly. And insults are only insults if you get hurt.
That's right.
And insults,
that's good.
You know, normally really it stems from their own insecurity. Yeah. So, yeah, we're all beautiful in our own ways.
That's right.
Okay. Oh, my God. I can't believe it's almost time to wrap up now.
It flies when you're having fun.
I know. Thank you so much for being on our show. Yeah. Thank you for being part of our crew. You're our crew now. Your family.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, everyone. Yeah. It's really time to wrap up the broadcast now. Our program is with IFES. Incheon aspires to become a city where Korean and English are spoken interchangeably. Our broadcast promotes to make Incheon the ideal city for residents to experience seamless interchangeability between Korean and English. So thank you all for listening, and I'll leave the Shawn Mendes There's Nothing Holding Me Back for today's last song. Enjoy the rest of this weekend. See you next Saturday.